Today is a big day, everybody. It's probably the biggest day that we've had in a while here at Nick Sands Presents, because today is the day of my very first film festival. That's right. It's happening right now. Well, about an hour from right now. I got almost everything I need. However, I don't like this shirt. And so, in typical fashion, no pun intended, I am going to buy a new shirt real quick at Walmart before I head out. Here's the crazy thing. I wear nice clothes so infrequently that almost every time that I need to do something like this, I need to buy a new shirt. Because I think the last time I wore a collared shirt was probably like 8 months ago. I'm a whole different person. Obviously, I've continued to push forward with my athletic physique, and I just don't really like this shirt. I think it looks stupid. When I bought it, I liked it. I don't know. I should probably get razors while I'm here too. And mints. What's a movie night without candy, you know?
Light it up, light it up. Pedal to the metal. We're gonna take it to a whole nother level tonight.
I think that's better. Okay, so now onward to Studio Lab.
A whole nother level. I don't know what we've been waiting for. It's time to hit it like we never ever hit it before. A whole nother level. Gotta go crazy, baby, that's who we are. Get up so high, we're looking down at the stars. Tonight, tonight, we're gonna blow it all out. Gonna show everybody.
And I'm now standing here with the president of FAIR, which is, I don't even know what it stands for.
All right, so FAIR stands for the Foster and Adoptive Resource Exchange. What we do is we provide grants for kids in care or kids adopted out of foster care to be able to participate in what we call normalcy activities. Karate, swim, gymnastics, all the normal stuff. When a kid comes into foster care, there's nothing normal about their life. When a foster family takes in 2, 3, 5 kids, it becomes a huge financial burden. So that's where we step in. So we also provide activities throughout the whole year. We put on large events for foster families. We do huge Christmas events where we provide hundreds and hundreds of gifts for people across the state. To date, I think we're just close to hitting the $100,000 mark in grants that we've given out to kids across the state.
What do you think is a misconception about fostering children or being a foster parent?
That they would get too attached and would not be able to leave the kids or let them go. That is what we hear from everybody. And newsflash, you do get too attached. That's the whole point. These kids deserve a foster home that's willing to get too attached, that's going to be heartbroken when they leave. It means you've done your job right. Every child deserves to have somebody's heart break for them when they leave.
Where can people find you to donate?
So we have several places. So our website is fairnh.org. We also have a Facebook page and an Instagram page, which is fairnh. You can find it. It's also got links to our emails and to the board members. So any variety of way you can reach out to one of us, and we will certainly give you the best avenue.
I'm now here with two of our entrants, the director and the main actress in a movie called The Guest on Topsfield Road. And so I'm just going to hand over the mic and let them talk about it a little bit.
I am the writer and director and producer for this particular short film, starring Jamie Lynn over here. Basically, a continuing series of our kind of Salem short films that we kind of have an ongoing Salem cinematic universe with a lot of different kind of characters and creatures of the night. And this one happens to be a ghost story.
Yes, it was a real honor for me to work on film with Luke, to be able to collaborate and make his vision come to life was truly an honor, and it was a really amazing project to work on.
Are you an actress? Is this your first?
It's been a while since I've been involved in anything, but I've done a ton of film work in LA back in my early 20s, which is forever ago. So finally, you know, life has had it circle back around for me, and I'm just starting to get back, you know, into the industry, and it's what's been missing out of my life, you know, all these years.
I just noticed you have something on your shirt. Where can people find your work?
I put the movie projects under the Thornfall Society, which is either, you know, online, Facebook, Instagram, or I have a webpage, lukestgermain.com.
And now we're here with Max Pollock, and he is the director of a film called Friend of a Friend, and we're with the main lead actress, Cassidy something. I told her I forgot her name before we started, and then she didn't tell me what it was again, so she kind of led me in there dry. I feel like every 20-year-old has felt like they're lost and don't know what to do, and I feel like you captured that in a way that was very interesting.
That was something that I really tried to. It's not necessarily that every 20-year-old fails, but it's certain that every 20-year-old feels like a failure. And what I really wanted to capture is for how awful you can feel about yourself in these moments and how real you can really kick yourself while you're down. I think it's important to show that everybody is on a journey, and that journey really does take one day at a time, and everybody is taking it one step at a time. And that's what I really wanted to show. I didn't want it to be this big thing where at the end she's suddenly all fixed and all of her problems have gone away. No, she still has a lot of work to do, but it was about taking that first step and that first courageous step towards, you know, bettering yourself that I was really trying to focus on.
And where can people find you?
Well, you want to go first?
Yeah, I have an Instagram page, just my first name.
Hold on, I was doing like a funny thing where I was moving the mic, and I think, can you just start over?
Yeah. I have an Instagram. It's Cass, K-A-S-S, Cranock.
Can you maybe spell that? I like how you spelled Cass and then didn't spell Cranock.
C-R-A-Y, or not C, oh my gosh. K-A-S-S-K-R-A-Y-K-N-O-C-K.
Cray.
No, oh my gosh, N-O-C-K.
Okay, wait, one more time?
Get a clean one.
Yes. K-A-S-S-K-R-A-Y-N-O-C-K. There we go.
You have passed the test. Good job.
There you go.
You may now leave the drum room. And where can people find you, Max?
I have a TikTok, Max D. Pollock Film, M-A-X-D-P-O-L-L-A-K. Film. And film is spelled the normal way.
Hate myself for having to say this, but can you do a TikTok dance?
I don't know any off the top of my head. I'm not on that side of TikTok, but if I did, I absolutely would
and
do
he's
one.
He's lying. He can do the apple dance.
Oh, I can do the apple
What's
dance.
What's the apple dance?
Right to the core, from all the things passed down from all the apples coming before. I split the apple down symmetrical lines and wanna find what's gonna.
This is a multi-talented man who deserves your respect. Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it. And now we are here with a gentleman by the name of Paul
Wybaracki.
There was no way I was even going to try that. You look like a movie star.
Oh, shucks.
And he was the lead in a movie called The Painter.
Correct.
What were you just an actor in that? Were you part of the writing? Were you?
I had nothing to do with the writing, all done by Jimmy Martin. The guy, he's a creative genius. I mean, he wrote it, he directed it, he edited it. The only thing he didn't do is pick up the camera and walk around with it.
Where can people find your work? Where can people find Jimmy's work? Where can we? Where would you like to plug?
JimmyMartin. Hold on. Oh, it's in my other jacket. JimmyMartin.com.
Oh, this is so embarrassing for you.
I actually have IMDb credits, believe it or not, as a choreographer for a film done for Lionsgate.
Can you dance too?
Yes, my wife and I are. I was a ballroom and Latin dancer for 40 years, and now my wife and I compete in country western dance. And we actually, in our division, we're the world champions.
Before you leave, can you dance here?
Sure, we'll do a step or two for you.
Don't leave until you dance for me.
You got it.
skunk eating lunch with a cross-eyed bear. You've been there. She was looking for something better than